Hi, I'm Paula D'Andrea for Rocky Life TV. And here we're ready to energize, transform, and rock with Wendy Bailey Schmidt. She is an expert on breathing. She's been a yoga teacher for over 9 years in different styles, teaching kids, working in Bikram, Kundalini, and what else do you do, Wendy?
I'm also a labor doula and visionary coach.
Okay, so definitely a lot of breathing involved in all of those things that you do.
Yes. through yoga, and then, of course, when you're going to conceive a baby, there's definitely a lot of breathing involved.
One of the most important things that you could be doing, right?
Yeah,
absolutely. So, and you find that, you know, and at those times when you're, you know, when you're teaching a class or when you're working with somebody getting ready to, you know, to deliver, there's a focus there. Let's talk for a second about the times that we aren't focused, when we're in our own little world, you know, like, you know, like when we're driving in traffic, you know, and you're stuck, you're late, you're this, you've got a zillion things on your mind, and it's all racing through, and you're grabbing onto the steering wheel and stuff like that. That's definitely a time where a lot of people are not breathing, would you agree?
Right. Yeah, everything gets constricted, we tighten up for defense, or
which doesn't do any good anywhere, because you're closing your body off, you're closing your mind off, you're closing your energy off, you know, everything is just in lockdown mode and locked onto that steering wheel.
Right.
What's one quick little thing that somebody could do in that situation, like just, you know, say they're stuck in traffic, you know, we're in Los Angeles, in case you didn't know, so a lot of traffic here, and just when you're sitting there, what's one quick thing that you could do to energize yourself, transform yourself in that moment, so then you can just totally rock out the situation?
I would just say some long, deep breathing, which sounds pretty simple, but can be a little bit more of a mechanical type of breathing, consciously allowing your breath to get very deep into your body. Mm-hmm. Do you want me to demonstrate on you? Would you be game
for
trying
some breathing?
Yeah, that'd
be awesome. Yeah, I'm sure, like, you know, because that's like one of the things is that, you know, I've done Kundalini, I've done, like, you know, more power, you know, type yoga and things like that. But the thing about it is again, it's like, you know, when we're consciously aware, which is what we want to do in Rocky Life TV, is make you consciously aware so that at all times you're able to, you know, energize, transform, and rock yourself out so that you're, you know, you're present and you're able to do something like breathe, to keep yourself on an even keel, you know, to be rocking out that higher vibe. And, you know, I'll find, you know, you feel it in your throat, in your chest. You know, when you get into your chest, it's like all breathing in through here, you know. Forget about the stomach.
So yeah, that's, it becomes like very fight-flight, like you're totally in protection mode and reactive mode, reacting to everything.
Yeah, and so it seems that, you know, that a lot of people just stay in that mode all the time until they do something like meditate, to go take a yoga class or something like that where they can shift their energy. But, you know, I really wanted to show people how they can bring themselves into that awareness to start doing it on a regular basis so it becomes more second nature. So what do I do? Am I good the way
so
I'm sitting?
You're great the way you're sitting. If you were driving in my car, I would say, you know, depending if you were a person who learns audibly, you know, who listens and starts to tune into things, you know, through listening, or if you're a person who likes to use imagery, or if you just really feel yourself all the time, I'd say those are the best tools for you to really find out how to connect with your breath and create a new relationship with it. So if you were a person who learned through listening, I would say to make sure that you're hearing your breath. You want it to be a little bit audible, and you want it to be soft, and you want to allow it to lengthen. So as you take a deep inhale, feel yourself bringing the breath all the way from your toes, and then all the way up, so you feel your belly come out. So you can really feel it. If you're a feeling person, you would feel the belly lengthening, expanding out. And as you exhale, you would just allow that breath to be long and deep, and you would be hearing it softly coming out. And you would be feeling it all the way down to the tips of your toes. So every inhale and exhale, you would want to start to lengthen in and in a mm-hmm. deep inhale and deep exhale.
Yeah, and that just made a whole, you know, that was totally mm-hmm. transformative.
Yeah, it doesn't take too long. That,
no, not at all. It's like, it's pretty instantaneous, and mm-hmm. it's just, you know, it's kind of like, I think the thing of it is that it allows you to pull yourself back into yourself.
Right.
You know?
Right.
Because we're constantly in situations where, you know, a lot of times our energy is going out to somewhere else. And mm-hmm. I think it's, you know, a lot more powerful to be able to have your energy first and then be able to walk into a situation rather than just kind of be walking into mm-hmm. a situation kind of like, you know, not really aware of it.
Right. So you're totally connecting more. Mm-hmm. And then as far as the physical, you're releasing endorphins in your body when you have a longer, deeper breath. If you think about the subtle, the prana, which is the inhale breath, that's the mm-hmm. life force that enters into your body, affects all of your emotions. And then apana, it's cleansing. So you're cleansing your body. But if you're just cleansing up here, you know, it's not a lot of room for that breath to move into to affect all of you.
And what's the importance of that? You know, I've heard this in the past, and you can help me and maybe help some other people mm-hmm. too, about, you know, the breathing, you're getting rid of dead air and allowing more oxygen into the stomach.
Mm-hmm. Like, our breath is nutrient rich and it's very oxygenated. So, you know, when you're working out even, so like in yoga, you're really feeding all those muscles with that deep breath. Mm-hmm. When you're just moving through life in general, you're allowing yourself to be more connected with the breath as far as a vehicle that you're moving with and not just like separate from you. You're allowing yourself to experience.
Yeah, that was actually, you know, yeah, exactly. I kind of caught myself in that, like going, listening to you and going, yeah, that sounds really good. Life force. And,
yeah,
you know,
yeah.
I feel like, you know, mm-hmm. like a plant, you know, mm-hmm. giving myself
yeah, it's
that.
Alkalining your mm-hmm. blood. Yeah. I mean, we go through so many different cleanses. We could just breathe deeper. We can actually cleanse our body.
That's
just
like
with the breath alone.
That's like the most natural cleanse, is yeah. just to breathe deeply.
Yeah, and if you think
well,
about it, like,
at a
subtle level, I mean, when we come into this world, you mm-hmm. know, since I work with babies, this is something that I'm always very in tune with, it's the first thing that happens. You know, the umbilical cord is cut. And there's a breath, a gasp of air, and then there's the crying. But there's the breath first.
That has to, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah,
that's what we come in with, right? That
exactly.
first breath.
Mm-hmm.
Breath and just.
And if you watch a baby breathe, mm-hmm. it's very. I mean, you can watch them; their whole body is breathing. Yeah, belly rises, and the whole body relaxes in.
Yeah, and I think you kind of go like when you know when I just did that exercise a couple minutes ago. It was like. You know, I felt like almost like I was listening to one of those tapes. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. People have the, or even, and it felt almost like a wave. You know, and when you mm-hmm. do that, you feel, you know, you can feel and see that rhythm.
See, that's the visual.
Total visual. So
yeah,
yeah. So it was like it was very much like that. And then, you know, I think it really it brings us back to that natural state of what we were born with. You know, when you are a baby, when you're younger, you know, you're not thinking about all these things, and you don't get caught up on, you know, on anything or anywhere. So
it's a great mm-hmm. tool for balancing the right hemisphere, the left hemisphere of the brain. But it's also a great tool to know that you are in control of your mind and your thoughts. Mm-hmm. You know, as soon as you start to let the thoughts create the reaction in your body, and you're breathing only in fight flight. Mm-hmm. You're not going to allow any new information to come in. You're going to be creating more of those bad patterns or going into those bad habits or bad patterns that you're probably trying to get rid of. You don't want to be just
exactly.
reacting, keeping
yeah,
in that same
totally.
Pattern.
And I think a lot of people do that too. So as a visionary coach, mm-hmm. I can see now, you know, that just kind of like really clicked for me when
yeah.
you said that, because, you know, you have the training of the yoga and the breath and a lot of things, awareness of the body and the mind and the heart mm-hmm. and bringing that in and helping people, you know, to start, you know, getting out of bad habits. And who thought that would all just start with breathing? Right,
right, exactly. But it's very, very connected. It's like one of the biggest things you can do, I feel, when you are trying to change some different things. If you think about, now this was very interesting. I learned this through Kundalini, but when you hold your breath, if you have a pattern that you're wanting to start to, or a habit you're starting to get rid of, you want to bring in something new, you just, and hold the breath.
I just did that. I was just because I'm sitting here talking. Yeah, about, I kind of felt myself doing that for a second while I was listening to you. And I'm like, no, start breathing.
But if you think about it, like when you were to blow out a candle on a birthday cake, mm-hmm. and make a wish, so it's the same type of thing. Make a wish, and you just let it go.
Yeah,
you can create a whole new neural pathway just with your breath. Very simple exercise, and you could do it in your car or wherever you're at, right before you're about to go into a meeting with your boss, or you're about to walk into the room after doing yoga, and you're coming home to all your children. You know, whatever it is, it's
just
simple.
Well, you need to have that transformation, because that's what it is. Mm-hmm. Is that, and the reason why we would do that is energize ourselves so that we can be in our space, we can be solid in that space, because then when you are in the room with other people, it allows you to just have that new environment, mm-hmm. have your own transformation, mm-hmm. that you bring into the environment, actually,
right.
that then you can
intentionally
help the situation, and that's rocking it out. That's like, the more that you can do that, I always call that rocking a higher vibe. So it's like, energize and transform and rock, and so that you're the more that you're in that space, the easier life is going to be.
Right?
Yeah. Okay. Cool. You also mentioned something about a neural pathway.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So I've done some Kundalini, and I know there's, we've done some exercises where you just kind of hold on the side mm-hmm, of your nose mm-hmm. and one side over the other.
Yeah.
What's the difference between left and right?
So if you were to close off your nostril, so there's a couple of different ways you can do this. This is great for after a hectic, stressful day, and you want to calm yourself down, mm-hmm. You close off your right nostril, and you're breathing in and out through your left nostril, and that's the moon energy. So it's a very cooling, relaxing energy. So you just use your thumb, and it will go. So your fingertips will be five fingers together, straight up next to your your thumb, and then it's a long, deep breath. So you're going right back to inhaling the breath up from the toes, visualizing expanding through your belly, through your lungs, through your shoulders. And as you exhale, you allow all that breath back out.
Feel it. It's different than the long, deep breath, for
mm-hmm,
sure.
Mm-hmm.
And there's also, you almost feel like something going on, buzzing on that side. That side of the brain that
exactly.
is doing. So then you do the same on the other side?
Yeah, you close off. Now, this would be for, you're tired, you're about to go into a meeting, you want some clarity, you want some projection, you want some energy. And this is going to be how you grab that sun energy. You take a deep inhale through the
I do feel the difference between. The energy was a lot different on the right side mm-hmm. than on the left. Seemed like really mellow, kind of like a more of a calming type of thing, and the right was more on the alertness side.
Mm-hmm.
Coolio.
And there's always through the day where you are going to be breathing from one nose passage more than the other.
Mm-hmm.
So depending on what you're going through, you can actually start to self-regulate. You want to do something a little different instead of grabbing that coffee mm-hmm. and something outside of yourself. You have all the tools inside of yourself to start to move with that, whichever energy is going to support what your focus is.
I like that.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Wendy, thank you
so much
for that. That was totally. I definitely walked away with
something
great to be able to do that. And how easy is that? Just breathe. Right? So with that, energize yourself, transform, and rock yourself out. I'm Paula D'Andrea with Wendy Bailey-Schmidt for Rock Your Life TV.